It's Brian Preston, the money guy.
All right, we've got a question from Kristen. Okay. She says, what are the best options to look into when investing within your 403B?
Okay.
The investment options available within mine are disappointingly limited, and getting HR to help make adjustments is a nightmare.
Oh, man. Okay.
So that is kind of a tricky spot to be in.
Yeah, so one of the things, you know, we've mentioned before that like Roth IRAs or individual accounts that you open up, you get access to the entire investment universe. When you work for an employer-sponsored retirement plan and you have access to a simple IRA or a 401k or a 457 or a 403b, normally there is just a lineup of investments you get to choose from. Sometimes it could be 10 investments, sometimes it could be 100 investments, and they're not all created equal. Some plans have really good low-cost index funds and they cover a majority of different asset classes, and there's a lot of different exposure you have. And some of them are really bad. It's very few investment options. They have high expenses. Maybe they're laden with insurance products. And unfortunately, when it comes to where you work, sometimes you're stuck in sort of this love the one you're with situation. So the first thing that we do is we say, okay, let's look at your current plan and let's determine which options are the best. Like, what are the pros of this plan? Maybe there are really good fixed income funds, or maybe there are really good equity, low cost index funds. And then we ask the question, okay, why are you contributing to the plan? So if it's a 403B, and one of the reasons that you are contributing is because you want to get tax savings this year, so you're doing pre-tax 403B contributions, well, the first thing I would encourage you to do is say, okay, well, go to your financial order of operations. Have you made it through step number one, step number two, step number three, step number four?
Got that free employer match? If you don't have that, again, you can find that for free at moneyguy.com/resources.
That's exactly right.
Or on our course at learn.moneyguy.com.
So you go through and determine, okay, if I've already got my free match and I've already maxed out my Roth IRA, I've maxed out my HSA, when I go back to maxing out the employer plan, if I'm someone who's in a higher tax bracket, maybe I'm in the 28, 30, 35, 37, potentially 30, you know, whatever that number is for you on the federal side, and then you add your state taxes to it, the tax benefit of contributing to the 403B may even outweigh the fact that the investment options aren't that great. It might be worth paying an extra 1% in fees if you can save 30 cents on every dollar that you put in there. So what I would do is I would assess, okay, what are the good options inside there? What do I have to work with? Now, here's one piece of advice I would tell you. I know you said that HR is
difficult,
frustrating, yeah. Nightmare. Kristen, I don't think you know, as a plan participant, just how much value and how powerful you can be. We have a real life story. One of our listeners, he was a longtime listener, longtime fan of the show, reached out to us and he said, guys, the 401k we have at work is just not great. Here's a list of the investment options. What do you think are some things I should ask? And, you know, this was a couple years ago, and I said, hey, well, ask about a Roth and then see if they can add, you know, these index funds. And if they can, ask them why. And so he sent that to HR. Like, he kind of did the work for him. Hey, these are the things we'd like to have. Why can't we do that? Well, the company that they were using said, oh, well, we can't use that. And the answers were like, because they're not available on our platform. We can't assess our fees on that. Like, it was just not great answers. So then he asked HR, hey, I've got this podcast at the time that I listened to. What if I were to bring them in? Would you let them pitch taking over our 401k? And then the rest of the story is we were able to take over that 401k, and we were able to implement a really good 401k with really low-cost investment options. We were able to save the company money and add benefits for the employees where they can now build their wealth in a much better way. I don't think you realize that just asking questions and then getting your coworkers to ask questions can influence that. Now, if it's a 403B, there's a chance it's like a hospital or a school system or something like that. You might not get to move away from whatever provider it is. But one thing you can do is ask, hey, can we have another provider? If we only have a VALIC option or an ING option, can we add Fidelity as a potential service provider? Or if we can't, could we add in these types of funds? You know, one of the things that's really interesting, Brian served on a large school board down in Georgia for a number of years. And one of the things he did early on was he was looking at the investment options, and like the 403B they had just wasn't great. It's a bunch of insurance products. He said, hey guys, why don't we talk to some of these low cost providers? Why don't we talk to the Vanguards and Fidelities of the world and see if they might be interested, at least just making an option available. And he was able to get that added just because he asked the question. So no one will be a larger advocate for you than yourself. So do a little bit of research, come up with, hey, here are some things I think we could change about the plan. What would it take for us to be able to do that inside of our plan? And you go from there.